I'm sorry, Governor, but I can't agree. It'd be like rewarding them for the riot.
It's only a barbecue, not a banquet. Sit down, will you? I'm speaking off the record, but it seems that you'll be replacing me as governor.
Really?
Now, the department is very anxious that the transition be as smooth as possible.
Naturally.
And for that reason, they've suggested we work together this week. It's up to you, of course.
Well, it suits me fine, Governor.
Of course, there's a lot of paperwork you'll have to become familiar with. Edna Pearson's appeal will be heard this afternoon, so that's one thing you won't have to worry about. But Desmond and Mitchell's hearings will be in your first week.
Foregone conclusions, wouldn't you say?
Desmond will almost certainly have more time added to her sentence, but it's hard to say what will happen to Mitchell. There's no actual proof that she did push Keane down those stairs.
Of course she did. The facts speak for themselves. Look what she did to Mr. Cruikshank.
I'd say your biggest problem will be Winter, but I'm afraid I can't offer any advice as to how to deal with her.
Yes, well, I have been giving the matter of Winter some thought.
And?
Well, I think it's best that we get rid of her. I'll see what I can do about having her transferred to Blackmore after her hearing. Of course, it might help, Governor, if you were to back me up on that.
I doubt it, but we'll try anyway.
Step right up, ladies. This cow's big enough for everybody. Here's yours, dude. Medium rare, just like you wanted it.
Oh, well, I'd eat it if it was raw, which it definitely isn't.
Damn boot leather, that's what it
is. Ah, stop whinging.
All right, it's got back teeth.
Hi.
Back
meat. It's a bit of a treat, isn't it? Huh?
Got here just in time, eh?
I'll say the cook is just about to knock off.
Thank you.
Bloody hell!
What's up?
I forgot to count myself, didn't I? I'm so hungry I could eat a maggoty horse, too.
Well, look, I'll do it for you. You go get yourself some shovel.
Oh, thanks, Bob.
An old bush's trick.
What's this for?
Here, let me show you.
Oh. I'm not joining them for a stake.
Oh, I'd love to, but I've got about 3 months' paperwork to catch up on before I leave. However, on a brighter note, Edna Pearson's appeal's been upheld.
Oh, wonderful. On what grounds?
Apparently inadmissible evidence about her first husband was used at the trial. And also, because of all the publicity she's been getting, the judge ruled that a fair retrial would be impossible.
Well, then she's free to go. Have you told her yet?
That's it. I was wondering if you'd go and get it for me.
Yes, of course. This is part of the job that I actually like.
Mm. Oh, I spoke to her husband. He's on his way over here now.
I bet they'll be doing some celebrating tonight.
I'll be in my office.
You really are a marvel, dear. I'd be happy to put you to work in my kitchen.
Oh, I probably won't know the difference between Mornay and Hollandaise by the time I get out of here.
Oh.
This is scrummy. Bobby done it spot on.
Looked at you, mate.
Pearson?
May I be first to congratulate you?
My appeal
has been upheld. Your husband's on his way down to the kitchen.
Hey, everybody, Edna's going to be released. Let's hear it for her.
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Thank you, thank you. I can't believe it. Oh, thank you. When do I leave, Mrs. Morris?
Well, now, unless you want to keep him waiting.
Oh, dear Harry, I'll write to you all. I promise.
Good on you.
Goodbye.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
Permission to go to the Dunny, Mrs. Barry.
All right, Winter, off you go.
I don't think I like the tone of your voice, Miss Ferguson. We made a deal, and I don't take too kindly to people who back down on deals. if that's what you're doing. Either you keep your end of the bargain or I shout so loud they're going to hear me in bloody Darwin. Did you get me?
It's incredible, isn't it? Here's this poor woman accused of poisoning her husband. Her husband says blind she didn't do it, and they still managed to stick her in here.
Yeah, it makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Yeah. Well, she's out now, that's the main thing. Come on, Sparrow, give us a hand.
Oh, I would love, but I can't work on a full stomach. Me pancreas would give me hell if I did.
Pancreas, eh?
It's got bits none of us have heard of.
Well, I reckon I've got one too, or else the steak was off. I should have just
come on, out. Rabbit, you don't get out of it, Daddy.
I'm not king. Oh, I've also got a knife in me gut.
Well, that does it then. If the cook is crook, we're all in trouble.
I'm serious, dude. Would you get me some help?
Oh, come off it, Rabbit. We got...
Oh! Hey, come on now. Quit clowning around.
Mrs. Barry! Mrs. Barry, quick, get the doctor!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again.